மணி ஓகேன்னு சொல்லிட்டு சொல்லிருங்க, நான் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிக்கிறேன். Okay. Good evening to all participants. On behalf of KPR Institute of Engineering and Technology, Department of Civil Engineering, I would like to welcome you all for Tech Webinar Series 9. I would like to introduce today's Chief Guest, Dr. R. Gopi. Dr. R. Gopi completed his BE Civil Engineering from Government College of Engineering, Salem, ME Structural Engineering from Bannari Amman Institute of Technology, Sathyamangalam. He obtained his PhD in the area of self-compacting concrete from Anand Institute, Chennai. Currently, he is working as an assistant professor, associate professor in the Department of Civil Engineering, Mari Lakshman Reddy Institute of Technology and Management, Hyderabad. He has 10 years of teaching experience. He published 8 papers in international reputed journals. He attended several national and international conferences. Now, I am handing over the session to Dr. R. Gopi, sir. Welcome you, sir. You kindly take over the session, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Ilango sir and coordinator for the webinar section. First of all, I thank to KPR Institute of Engineering Technology for giving me the opportunity to share my knowledge in the area of my research. And this presentation will be very useful for the UG students, PG students, faculties and research college also who are interested in concrete technology. This presentation is about lightweight concrete and lightweight aggregates. So before going to the presentation, first of all, I asked to participants one question. So please see this last slide. This slide shows a concrete cube, 150 mm concrete cube floating in the water. So it is like a floating concrete. Okay. So now I'm asking one simple question. What is the weight of this concrete? If we have 150 mm concrete cube, 150 mm concrete cube, the condition is it should be floating. Okay. So now what is the weight of that cube? So you know, normally the weight of the concrete cube is around 8 kg. For one concrete cube having 150 mm size. Okay. So that is, it will immerse in the water, submerged in the water. For floating concrete, what is the weight? Okay. So we will see the answer at the last. Now I am going to the presentation. So my presentation is mainly focused on lightweight aggregates. So before going to lightweight aggregates and its characteristics, so first we have to know what is lightweight concrete. So this is my overview of the presentation. So lightweight concrete introduction, materials for lightweight concrete, advantages and disadvantages, applications of lightweight concrete. Next, I'm coming to the lightweight aggregate introduction, types, properties, and other phase of the lightweight, other advantages of the lightweight aggregate, that is internal curing or self curing of the lightweight using lightweight aggregate. Okay, first we will see the lightweight concrete. Okay, what is lightweight concrete? Okay, so the question itself having answer. So it should be less density compared to the normal weight concrete. You know that for normal weight concrete, it's around 2300 kg per meter cube to 2600 kg per meter cube. So whenever we are designing a RCC structure or RCC calculation, we are using for RCC purpose 2500 kg per meter cube. For PCC purpose, 2400 kg per meter cube. Okay, so this is the normal weight concrete. Now, what is lightweight concrete? So the lightweight concrete having density 300 kg per meter cube to 1900 kg per meter cube. Okay, when the concrete density is between 300 to 1900 means, so it is called a lightweight concrete. Okay, this is one of the special type of concrete. So how to achieve this lightweight concrete? There are three modes available. Okay. So let us see one by one. So by using first using porous lightweight aggregate having very low specific gravity. You know that normal specific aggregate specific gravity is around 2.6 to 2.8, both fine aggregate as plus coarse aggregate, it is 2.6 to 2.8. okay, for lightweight aggregate the specific gravity is less than 2.6. okay, so why is the specific gravity very, very less means having numerous voids or porous, so then on, for that only it is reduced, specific gravity is reduced. This is the first method. The second method is by introducing large voids. So externally we have to introducing large voids. Okay, so by using foam. Okay, so how foam is generated? The foaming agent. Okay, it acts as a foaming agent. So this foam when hardened, so it gives the very reduced density concrete. Okay, so it also called aerated, cellular, foamed or gas concrete. There are numerous names are there. So next, third, no fines concrete. So you know that fine aggregate, if particle size is less than 4.75 mm, it is called fine aggregate. So in the no fines concrete there is no filler material, that means there is no fine aggregate. Okay, only a coarse aggregate and cement and water. Okay, so this some amount of density will be reduced. For example, in pervious concrete and some other concrete also we have produced without fine aggregate. Okay, these are the three ways available to produce a lightweight concrete. So next, what are the main advantages? There are numerous advantages are there for lightweight concrete. The first foremost important is it reduces the dead load of the building. Okay, so if consider one slab, so that's the slab thickness is 100 mm. okay, so that means 0.1 meter. okay, so normally we are using normal concrete having density 25 kiloton per meter cube. So the what is the weight of the slab? So 0.1 is 25, we get 2.5 kilonewton per meter square. So we know that minimum thickness of the slab is 0.1 meter. Okay, so it is around 2.5 kilonewton per meter square. So you know that as per IS 875 part 2, the imposed load on the residential building is around 2 kilonewton per meter square. It is given by the code IS 875 part 2. So here you can see compared to live load, that means that imposed load 2 kilonewton per meter square, the dead load is more. Okay, the dead load is more, it is 2.5 kilonewton per meter square. So here always in if you used in normal concrete, always compared to live load, dead load is more. So it is not an economical point of view. Okay, so when suppose if you use lightweight concrete having density 1500 kilonewton kg per meter cube, so if you multiply by the 0.1 into 15, we get an answer of 1.5 kilonewton per meter cube of dead weight. So significantly it is reduced from the live load. So it is a very economical one. Okay, so whenever compared to live load, the dead load value is low, means we can make the structure as very economical. We can design the structure as very economical. Okay, because the reinforcement and size of the member, everything depends upon the load only, and it's that load creates moments. That moments only major factor for design of reinforcement and cross section of the member. Dead load is reduced automatically, reinforcement percentage and size of the member is reduced. So automatically the cost will be very economical one. That is the major thing. And the second thing, easy to handle. Okay, so due to its very lightness, it is easy to handle, hence reduce the cost of transportation and handling, and it gives improves workability also. And lightweight concrete has a lower thermal conductivity. This is very, very important, one of the major advantages. So it gives good thermal conductivity, lower thermal conductivity. Okay, because of, so there are numerous pores in the lightweight aggregate and also lightweight concrete, which can use in lightweight concrete. So that porous act as a cavity. So it is the barrier of the thermal conductivity. Okay. Next thing, good resistance to freezing and thawing action when compared to conventional concrete. So next use, the use of lightweight concrete gives an outlet for industrial waste such as fly ash, clinker, slag, etc. So nowadays researchers are going on to make pellets. So fine aggregates, that means river sands, are now we get more scarcity. So for that purpose only we are using M sand and some other materials as a filler material. Okay, so to make an industrial byproduct into pellets, small sized pellets, or it gives both the fine aggregate and the coarse aggregate, means it is very beneficial one and economical one also. Okay, so there are lot of researches going on to make this type of fly ash, bagasse ash, rice ash, and other type of ash, bottom ash, to make into aggregate. Okay, so that process is called a pelletization process. And also it having this type of materials having good pozzolanic activity also. So this pozzolanic activity improves the durable strength and durability of the lightweight concrete. So next use, it offers great fire resistance due to its lightness and more cavity in the concrete. And lightweight concrete gives overall economy compared to normal weight concrete. Okay. Next, what are the disadvantages? So some few disadvantages is there. Okay. So let us see one by one. So lightweight concrete is generally very sensitive with water content in the mixture. So we can't use lightweight aggregate in a dry state. Okay, so if you used lightweight aggregate in your concrete, in a lightweight concrete in dry state, means what happened, means the dry lightweight aggregate absorb water from the concrete, that mixing water we apply now in that concrete, it absorbs. So we can get a very, very stiff, it affects the workability also, very stiff concrete. Okay, so what we have to do before applying into the concrete mixture, so we have to wet, we have to wet the lightweight aggregate before applying into it. Major difficult to place because of porosity and quality, definitely in some cases may break the aggregate and make it float on the surface of the concrete. This is the another major disadvantage. So whenever we use the lightweight aggregate in the concrete, some lightweight aggregate density is less than the water. That means you know that water density is 1000 kg per meter cube, but the lightweight aggregate density is only 800 kg per meter cube, means so automatically it comes to top of the concrete. So the mix, so segregation occurs, the mix will not in a proper way. So what happened means, so the aggregate is separated during compaction, so all the lightweight aggregates are comes up. Okay, it is not, it's not gives a proper mix. Okay, so we have to adjust the water cement ratio. If you control, if you adjust the water cement ratio, means a uniform blend of mix is achieved. So after that, before going to apply to the major portion, we have to test initially. After that only we have to apply in the major part. Okay. So next thing is mixing time is comparatively longer than conventional concrete. So as to assure proper mixing of concrete. So for a normal concrete we can easily mix, but whenever we use lightweight aggregate or some other material in the, into the concrete, So we have to give more mixing time. So for the uniform blend of the mix. Okay, this is also one some of the disadvantages of the lightweight concrete. Next, applications. So where we have to use this type of lightweight concrete? Since the strength of lightweight concrete is very low, it is used in the construction of roof slabs, small houses with the load bearing mass, etc. So for normal concrete, we have to use mineral admixtures and super plasticizers, chemical admixtures, everything. So we have to achieve around M60, 80, even 100 also. But in lightweight concrete, it will not achieve that much strength. Okay. So lightweight concrete, we can achieve up to M40 or 50 only. We can't go beyond that. So lot of research is going on. So even though we can't go beyond. Okay. So maximum strength is M50. So it also used in the construction of stairs, windows, under garden walls, etc. So in large building construction, this is used in the construction of partition wall. That means non-load bearing walls. Okay. So these are molded in the form of slabs and used in thermal insulator inside the building. So lightweight concrete is a very good thermal insulator. So we can use as a partition wall in the buildings. So this is all about the lightweight concrete. So next we move to lightweight aggregate. Okay, what is the difference between normal weight aggregate and lightweight aggregate? So we know that normal aggregate density is around 1500 2600 range. Okay, but lightweight aggregate, if you are telling this is the lightweight aggregate, means that material density is around 400 to 1150 kg per meter cube. 400 to 1150 kg per meter cube. So this range only it is called a lightweight aggregate. So what are the properties? So how it is very less density because of is porous in nature. Okay, very porous. More number of voids are there. Interconnected voids are there. Next, low density and high water absorption and retention capacity. So it absorbs. So for normal weight aggregate, it absorbs around 1% or 2% welding. I'm telling about coarse aggregate. Okay, but lightweight aggregate, it absorbs around 10% even 20% also, because there is lot of porous is there inside the lightweight aggregate. I will show you in the picture. So in that parts are filled with water. The walls are filled with water. Automatically, more water, and it gives more water retention capacity. So that measure used in horticulture. So once it absorbs water, more retention. So in horticulture department, this lightweight aggregates are highly used. Next is also insulate property. Okay, lightweight aggregate produce high insulating materials. So please see the picture. These are the small plants for the department, grown from horticulture department. So you can see this pebbles like aggregate. Okay, so it will retain water up to 3 days. So daily we don't put water for this type of plants. Okay, so once you put water 1 day, means it will retain up to 5 days also. So majorly it is used in horticulture department. Next, types of lightweight aggregates. So there are two major categories of lightweight aggregates. First one is natural lightweight aggregate, artificial lightweight aggregate. Okay, natural means it is available in nature. Artificial means it is a man-made lightweight aggregate. Okay, so in natural lightweight aggregates, mainly It is coming from molten lava. Molten lava. Okay, during volcano eruption, the molten lava coming now. That molten lava. Okay, and majorly it will come in molten lava. And artificial aggregates are derived from clay and fly ash and some other materials. We will see one by one. Okay, these are all the major categories: natural and artificial. Okay. So we will see some of this important lightweight aggregates one by one. Okay, so next, first one is pumice aggregate. Can anybody see this stone in supermarket? So this is available in major all the supermarkets. Okay, so what purpose? So it will cure the cracks in our heel. Okay, so this is called a pumice stone. Okay, in a market, in the brand name of it is called a pumice stone. Okay, so this is the pumice type of aggregate having large promer, large pores. It contains large pores. So it is one of the natural lightweight aggregate which is formed by the sudden cooling of molten volcanic matter. That means that lava. Pumice is formed during the volcanic eruption of viscous magma. Pumice is notably one of the most common and the oldest of naturally occurring aggregate utilized lightweight coarse aggregate used for the production of concrete for construction industry. So in pumice aggregate is the first and foremost aggregate used by the Roman peoples in that long year back Roman structures are constructed using this pumice aggregate. So olden days also they used lightweight aggregate using this pumice. So their lightness is due to escaping of gas from the molten lava when erupted from the deep beneath the earth crust. Okay, so the pumice aggregate having density around 600 kg per meter cube. Okay, this is the important pumice aggregate. So next, so pumice stone is available in Amazon, Flipkart and everything. Okay, in all the so around 1 kg is around 250 rupees. Okay, so if you want to buy, means you can order in Amazon and Flipkart also. So next natural lightweight aggregate is diatomite. So it is derived from the remains of microscopic aquatic plants called diatoms. So this diatomite is available in seashore under the sea. Okay, so that one type of aquatic plants, this is the one type of aquatic plants, that plants is called diatoms. It is available in sea areas. Okay, the deposit of aquatic plants are formed beneath the deep ocean bed. Okay, so this bulk density is comparatively less than the pumice aggregates, around 450 kg per meter cube. It is also act as a pozzolanic material. The silicious content is more in this diatomite. The silica content is more, so it act as a pozzolanic material. So diatom is also available in online. We can get, so around 5 kg. It's around 650 rupees. 5 kg. It is around 650 rupees. So why I am showing this type of slide means. So if any people want to do research in lightweight aggregate means, they can search. So initially during my research, I searched this diatomaceous material. So on that day, that means 10 years back, I didn't get this material. So for that only I shifted to Leica aggregate. Okay, so now it is available. So anybody want to do research means, I give you a platform. Okay, to where we have, you have to buy this material. So this slides are very helpful to you. Next is sawdust. Sawdust is nothing but the wood derived powder. Okay, when sawing the wood, there will be a powder is coming now, that is called a sawdust. So it is very very light compared to other two. In floor, we can it can be used in flooring and in the manufacture of precast products. The density of sawdust is around 210 kg per meter cube, very very less. So the sawdust is easily available in carpentry shop. Okay, we can easily we can get at free of cost. Next is scoria. Scoria also like pumice stone. Okay, so this also one of the volcanic matter only. It's also porous, reddish or black in color. There are two colors are available for scoria. One is reddish or black in color. Okay, so concrete produced using scoria aggregate can insulate heat 5 to 7 times better than the concrete produced using conventional aggregate. So this is the very good insulating material. Okay, compared to conventional aggregate. And also mainly act as a thermal insulating material. So the density of scoria is somewhat high. It's around 1100 kg per meter cube. So in India, scoria is not available that much. So I searched in India Mart, only one company, that is Luxury Part New Delhi, that one company is selling the scoria. So the price is per kg 450 rupees. Per kg 450. You can search in India Mart. We can get. So next. So far we've seen natural aggregates. These are all the three most important natural aggregates. Okay. So next we will go for artificial aggregate. Okay. So an artificial means man-made aggregate. So the first foremost important is LECA aggregate. So in my research I used this aggregate one day in self-compacting concrete. So LECA is a light expanded clay. So it is the clay based aggregate. So it is a special type of lightweight aggregate that has been pelletized and fired in a rotary kiln. So on a rotary kiln around a temperature 1200 degrees Celsius, this clay materials are fired. And the rotary kiln will be always, it is rotating one. Okay, so it forms a pelletized product. That product is called LECA. Okay, so as it is fired, the organic compounds are burned off, forcing the pellets to expand and become honeycombed. The inside of the LECA aggregate is very much honeycombed structure. The resulting pellets are very lightweight, porous, and have a high crushing strength. So we can't break this lightweight aggregate in our hand. We need some hammer. So even though it is lightweight, it is very, very hard in nature. Okay. And the density of LECA ranges from 400 to 800 kg per meter cube. Okay. So LECA aggregate also available in Amazon. It's around 30 kg, around 2,700 rupees. Okay. So 10 years back, during my research, I brought from GBC India Private Limited from Ahmedabad. So that company is the wholesale seller of the lightweight aggregate to the entire India. So I brought from GBC India. Okay. At that time, we can't get this type of material in Amazon or Flipkart or any online. Okay. So I brought from GBC India. You can search in Google. They are selling varieties of greener material like this type of LECA. Some other materials also is there. You can search in go to that website, GBC India, Ahmedabad. So next, expanded shale and slate. So this also same like expander clay aggregate. Okay. Expander shale is mined, crushed and fired under higher temperature around 1100 degrees Celsius in a rotary kiln, producing a clean, inert, porous and light material, and density also moreover same as per LECA, around 400 to 800 kg per meter cube. So compared to LECA, this expanded shell rate is somewhat less. So it's around 30 kg, it's around 690 rupees or 700 something. Okay, so in India Mart it is available. This material is available in India Mart. If you want to buy means, you can go to India Mart and contact the supplier. Next, cylinder fired aggregate. Okay, So we know that fly ash is derived from fly ash is we got from thermal power plants. So it is one of the waste material from thermal power plants. After burning the coal, pulverized coal, so we can get this fly ash material. Okay. So so mainly fly ash is used in brick industry. So nowadays all are moving into fly ash bricks. Okay. So this is the another construction materials. Okay, fly ash aggregate. So we can make the fly ash into aggregate. So fly ash is the powder. So how to convert this into aggregate? So using this cinder method. So another method is also is called is there, that is called cold bonded fly ash aggregate method. Okay, so here we will see the cinder fly ash. Okay, say above 90% of fly ash mixed with water, and in some cases a small volume of additives also. Additive means small amount of cement also for a bonding purpose. Okay, so after agglomeration and pelletizing, the green pellets are sintered. So there are separate machine is there for pelletizing the materials. Okay, so if not using that equipment, means we can use concrete mixture also, our normal concrete mixture also, to produce this type of pellets. The green pellets are sintered at high temperature, producing lightweight aggregate. So the characteristics are similar to natural aggregate. So we can get the different types of sizes. Okay, we can't get a uniform size. We can get a different types of sizes of the pellets. So after drying, we can sieve it. So what are our requirements? Either coarse aggregate or fine aggregate. Based on that, we can sieve these pellets. So these are all the typical physical characteristics. So for aggregate size, we can get from 5 to 16 mm, and bulk density is 650 to 950 kg per meter cube. Particle density 1250 and 2450 kg per meter cube, and aggregate crushing strength it is equal to or more than 5 MPa, and water absorption equal to or less than 22%. Okay, so this is called cinder fly ash aggregate. Cindering means firing. It's type of heating. Okay, so here heating is the process to make the fly ash aggregate in the pelletizing machine. So fly ash, lightweight fly ash aggregate is available in India Mart. It is very very cheap material, around 1 kg equal to rupees 20 only in India Mart. Okay, you can search in India Mart. Next one, important one, is perlite. So far we seen some of the aggregate, that is for normal weight aggregate, normal weight concrete, and the structural concrete purpose. Okay, so now we will see the how to produce ultra lightweight concrete. That means density is very very less, around 300 kg per meter cube to 500 kg per meter cube. How to produce that density of concrete, ultra lightweight concrete? So one of the major material we can use is called perlite. So perlite is an amorphous volcanic glass that has relatively high water content, that is 2 to 5. So naturally it having some water content. It occurs naturally and has the unusual property of greatly expanding. So when heated, that water is escaping. So due to this, the aggregate will expand. So it is an industrial mineral and a commercial product useful for its lightweight after processing. The density of perlite around only 30 to 150 kg per meter cube. Please see this density. This is very 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 ultra lightweight. Okay, 30 to 150 kg per meter cube. So perlite is we can get from Amazon and Flipkart also. There are lot of companies they are selling the perlite. Okay, so amount also somewhat very cheap. 1 kg is around 249 to 250 rupees. Okay, so we can get small amount as well as large amount from Amazon on Flipkart. Next, explorative vermiplay. Okay, it is like a mica like product. It is like a flaky. It is large flakes are there. Flaky product. So vermiclite is a naturally occurring mineral composed of shiny flaky, resembling mica. Okay. So whenever you show this vermiclite in sunlight or some other light, means it will be shining. Okay, it is like a flaking. Okay, it is produced in different grades or sizes. When heated to high temperature, the vermiclite flakes expand 8 to 30 times. Depends upon the property of the vermiclite. It expand 8 to 30 times their original size. Okay, so that expansion, the process is called exploration. And very 8 to 30 times the original size and lost their weight. Mostly exploratory vermiculite is used in different markets, namely horticultural, agricultural, construction and industry. So density also very, very less to make ultra lightweight concrete. So density around 200 kg per meter cube. Okay. So in horticulture, this material is very much used. So we can buy it in Amazon. So 5 kg around 570 rupees, 570 to 600 rupees. It is easily available. Next, formed slag. This is also one of the formed slag. The lightweight cellular material obtained from controlled processing of molten blast furnace slag. Okay, so we have to use blast furnace slag and water under controlled temperature. We can get this type of formed slag aggregate. The density is around 800 kg per meter cube to 1040 kg per meter cube. So this is also available from India Mart. So far we seen different types of aggregate. Okay. So the ACA code 213R87 gives the, there are different concrete types based, different types of aggregate based on its density, and also gives the concrete based on the concrete types based on its density. For low density concrete, we have to use perlite and vermiculite. Okay. So in x-axis, it shows kg per meter cube. That means this is the density of concrete, not aggregate. Please keep it in mind that x-axis shows density of concrete, not aggregate. So for low density concrete up to 800, between 300 to 800, we have to use only perlite and vermiculite. We have to produce lightweight density concrete, means only we have to use perlite and vermiculite. And 800 to 1400 kg per meter cube, it is called moderate strength concrete. So we have to use pumice and scoria and somewhat perlite also. Pumice, scoria and somewhat perlite. Okay. So next, for in case of structural purpose, that means RCC concrete, so we have to use some other materials, another material, expander slag, shell, fly ash aggregate and light expander, that means light expander clay aggregate, LICA, and some other materials, fly ash aggregate and some cinder or cold band fly ash aggregate. So the density range is 1400 to 1900 kg per meter cube. Okay, this chart gives the ranges of the density of the concrete as well as the material we have to use as aggregate. Okay, so far we seen about the lightweight concrete and the lightweight aggregate. So there is a other phase is there for the lightweight concrete, other beneficial phase is there. Okay, so that is called internal curing or self curing. So in this slide we will discuss about that one. So American Concrete Institute, ACI, defines internal curing. What is that internal curing means? A process by which the hydration of cement continues because of the availability of internal water that is not part of the mixing water. So what is by curing? So curing means we have to maintain sufficient moisture content in the concrete for the full hydration of the concrete. So without curing, we can't achieve strength and durability and other inherent properties. For a good concrete, curing is enough. Without curing, we can't achieve good concrete. So for normal, we are doing conventional curing. What we have to do? So please see this picture, external curing. This is a conventional, consider this is a conventional concrete slab. So after casting that slab, we are applying, next day we are applying water. Okay. So the surface, that means the top surface of the slab is very much cured. What about that bottom? Bottom we can't cure. If we constructed a column, means we are you for curing purpose, we are using gunny bags. So entire all the four sides we can be able to cure. But what about slab? Only top surface only we can able to cure. What about the bottom side? We can't able to cure because we provide the shuttering. Minimum 14 days or 21 days it should be there. So it is not a 100% cure cured. Okay. So to overcome this problem, we introduced water filled lightweight aggregate. So what is meant by water filled lightweight aggregate? So before applying the lightweight aggregate into the concrete, we have to submerge it for 24 hours in water before the concreting work. So after 24 hours, you take into the concrete, take into the aggregate, and make into saturated surface like condition. Okay, so we can't apply as it is. We have to surface dry first. So after that, so now the density of the aggregate will be increased due to the water is filled in the porous, in the voids of the aggregate, lightweight aggregate. So after that, you apply in the concrete. Okay. So now, see the second picture, the initial instruction. The blue color is a water-filled aggregate. So during concrete hardening, the water filled in the aggregate which release the water. Okay. So the bonding between the aggregate and the cement paste is very much important. So that bonding gives the strength of the concrete. Without if bonding is broken without proper curing, if the bonding will broken and the concrete will not achieve the proper strength. Okay, so simply saying, for example, concrete is like our human being. Okay, so we are drinking for a good drinking water. Concrete also need good drinking water. Concrete will not concrete will not need a chemical bond water or other polluted water. We also don't need. Suppose we are suffering from fever or other some other diseases. We went to doctor, we meet doctors, doctor gives some put some injection or give some tablets. We are taking inside only. We are not taking outside. Okay. So the tablets and the injection, it will cure internally in our body. Cure the diseases or summer fever, everything. Okay. So same thing here, also same thing. So this water filled aggregate, it serves as a curing agent to the concrete to make 100% cure of the concrete. It actually good concrete. Okay. You can see this picture. This is the micro level picture of the interface between aggregate and cement paste. Okay, so you can see the lightweight aggregate absorbed water and contact zone. Absorbed water moves from aggregate into the paste. Okay, so the initially absorbed water after some time, that means here the picture shows after 1 week. So after 1 week, it release water to the surrounding cement paste in the contact zone. So the surrounding cement paste achieve good hydration. Okay, if good hydration achieves, means the concrete will give more strength and durability also more. Okay, so this is the function. This is the another phase of the lightweight aggregate. Okay, so the strength of the concrete is increased as the bond between the lightweight aggregate and the hydrated cement paste becomes continuous due to decreasing permeability. So what are the advantages? So achieve good bonding between cement paste and aggregate as we seen earlier, and a considerable water saving. So if you use lightweight aggregate in the concrete, we don't need external curing. So considerable water saving is there. Okay, so literatures are saying 1 meter cube of concrete needed 3 meter cube of water. Just imagine, 1 meter cube of concrete need for a mixing as well as curing purpose, 3 meter cube of concrete, 3 meter cube of water needed to cure that specimen as well as mixing. Okay, so plenty of water, good drinking water is wasted. Okay, for curing purpose. So if you use this type of technique, we can considerably reduce that water. Okay, so we can use both as well as a lightweight aggregate and as well as external curing also possible, but not that much water. Just we have to spray to the external surface, because external surface is drying quickly due to the direct sunlight contact with the surface of the concrete. Okay, so we can just spray. Spraying is enough. Next, reduce the shrinkage cracking. Okay, and reduce the permeability, provide greater durability, increase the yearly age strength, improved rheology, and no manpower required for curing. That is one of the major advantages. Okay, so and these are the reference available for lightweight concrete and internal curing concrete. Okay, so there are ASTM standards are there, C330 standard specification for lightweight aggregate for structural concrete, and ASTM C1761, this is the latest one, lightweight aggregate for internal curing of concrete. And Indian standards are also there, IS 6042, code of practice for construction of lightweight concrete block masonry, and IS 9142, specification of artificial lightweight aggregate. So specification for artificial lightweight aggregate for masonry units. Okay, so if researcher want to study more about lightweight concrete or lightweight aggregate means, please buy this book. It is available in Flipkart, but cost is more. It is around 26,121. The title of the book is Lightweight Aggregate Concrete. It deals only lightweight aggregate types, characteristics, and the micro level analysis and everything, advantages, disadvantages in the lightweight concrete, everything. Okay, this book is around 26,121. If anybody I have this book's soft copy. If any researchers or students, faculties want this book, means kindly mail to me a request. I will send you into the mail. And this is also another book, Structural Lightweight Aggregate Concrete. This dealing about structural lightweight aggregate, and this cost also very high. It is around 30,510. Okay, so this is the Short Ganga website. Most of the faculties may know this is a reservoir for Indian thesis. So some of the thesis available related to lightweight aggregate concrete and the lightweight concrete. So even my thesis also available as a 7th one experimental. I used lightweight aggregate as internal curing aggregate in self-compacting concrete. So my thesis is experimental studies on self-compacting concrete with self-curing using light expander clay and a fly ash aggregate. I used 2 types of lightweight aggregate for my research, light expander clay and a fly ash aggregate, under the guidance of Dr. V. Ravali, HOD Civil, KSR College of Engineering. So there are number of around 10 theses available. You can easily download from Short Ganga website. Okay, so now we will come the last slide. So at starting, I asked one question, that is, what is the weight of the concrete cube? The condition it should be float in the water. Okay, so normal concrete weight is, cube weight is around 8 kg. Okay, so how to find? I think some of the faculties are found. So just I will give the solution for this. So suppose concrete cube size 0.15 into 0.15 into 0.15. So normal weight of concrete 2400 means it's around 8.1 kg normal weight. So we know that density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. Okay, what is the condition for the lightweight concrete for floating mean? It should be less than the density of water. Okay, so multiplied by 1000. Okay, so finally we get 3.375. So when the density of that concrete cube, that 150 mm concrete cube, weight less than 3.375, it should be float in the concrete. Okay, this is the answer for that one. Okay, so after this I am concluding my session. So thank you for the participants, faculties and coordinators for giving me the opportunity to deliver this keynote address and share my knowledge. So thank you. So any queries means you can ask.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lango sir.
Thank you, Dr. Gobi sir. Thank you. Am I audible? Thank you. Sir, I'm having I'm having a few questions from participant science. I would like to ask some questions to you. Sir, actually one participant has asked that let me use a coconut shell as lightweight aggregate. Means raw coconut shell or powdered form, which one is better?
Sir, I can't hear you.
Sir, can we use coconut shell as lightweight aggregate?
Okay, sir.
Shall we use coconut shell as lightweight aggregate? If it is used, means either powdered form or raw coconut shell, which one is better?
Okay, sir. So some of the researchers are doing a coconut shell aggregate as a lightweight aggregate, but check the density. If the density is within that lightweight aggregate range, that means below the 1150 kg per meter cube, means for 1 meter for the density is lower, means we can use the lightweight aggregate as a coconut shell as a lightweight aggregate, no problem. And also we can use in a powder form also, but in powder form means you have to make into pelletize. Okay, so first we have to make into pelletize, after that only we have to use. We can't use as a raw ash. Okay, first we have to use pelletize. There is a procedure is there in the net also available. In my thesis also I given the pelletization process. Please go through, sir. Thank you.
Sir, another question. To make lightweight concrete, whether normal mixing is enough, any other special mixing used to be done?
Okay, sir. This is another important point. So for normal mix design is not there, sir. Okay, for lightweight concrete there is a special mix design is there. Here we have to use less water content. We have to achieve more strength. We have to use less water content, and there is no specific code is there. Okay, there is no specific code. Based on trial and error method only we have to use. First try with our code. Okay, our code also may be achieved, but I didn't try because my research in self-compacted concrete. Okay, I didn't try. First you try with our code. Use coarse aggregate as lightweight aggregate. Okay, you can use lightweight aggregate as a coarse aggregate. Don't put fine aggregate, because major part of concrete is aggregate only. Around 75 to 80% aggregate only. Okay, so you replace coarse aggregate, normal coarse aggregate, into lightweight aggregate. Whether it is achieved, density is less means you can use that, no problem. Next question, sir.
Sir, one last question, sir. How will be the durability of lightweight concrete when compared to normal concrete?
Okay, sir. So it is depends upon the material, sir. So normally the natural lightweight aggregates are more durable than artificial lightweight aggregates. Okay. So durability is, it gives very good durability and very good insulating property also. Okay. So because of the pore structure, okay. So somewhat in some durability tests, it may fail. So I seen one literature. So in that literature, they use lightweight aggregate as a coarse aggregate. Before applying the concrete, they coated with bitumen. They coated with bitumen around the lightweight aggregate. So after that, they used. Okay. So this bitumen means it gives bitumen resists some durability. It does not affect some durability properties. So it gives the good durability point of view. Okay. So if you want to do more durable concrete, lightweight concrete means, please use natural lightweight aggregate. Okay, sir. Next question, sir. Any other?
Sir, whether another one question from participant side, sir.
Okay, sir.
The last question. If Lika is made from clay or fly ash, won't it melt in contact with water? When it is contact with water, whether it will melt or it will not melt? That one, sir.
No, sir. Actually, Lika is a very hard material. Very hard material. It is produced from clay only. A special type of clay only. When it is in a lottery kiln, it fired with 1200 degrees Celsius. What happened means it will be expand and it form a nodular shape. That means a spherical shape. Spherical shape balls. Okay. So it will not react with water. Okay, you don't worry. I used this Lika material. It's a very good material. It's also used in horticulture department also. So we can make lightweight concrete using this Lika aggregate. So it will not melt with water. Okay, and also the Lika is very good material in durability point of view. I used this material and tested with acid resistant and salt resistance. It gives good results. Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Rajesh, sir, please.
Thank you, sir. I would like to thank all the participants for attending the webinar on lightweight aggregate and its influence in concrete. I also thank today's chief guest, Dr. R. Gobi, for his informative speech. Last but not least, I would like to thank our beloved HOD, Dr. G. Anusha, faculty members of Civil Engineering Department and KPR Management, Principal Ma'am, for providing such an opportunity to conduct a webinar. Thank you. Thank you all.
Okay, thank you. Any participant any questions or any material means, you can just mail to me. My mail ID given in the first slide. I will share my idea and help to you. Thank you, sir.
I am also posted your mail ID in the chat box. Participants will use that mail ID. Dr. Gobi, sir, thank you for your valuable and informative session. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Shall I leave, sir?
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, you can leave, sir. Thank you, sir. Okay, thank you. Okay.